हेलो स्टूडेंट, आई एम अमित कुमार यादव फ्रॉम इलेक्ट्रिकल डिपार्टमेंट SIIT कॉलेज भोपाल। टुडे इन द 13th लेक्चर ऑफ मैग्नेटिक सर्किट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस प्रैक्टिकल ट्रांसफॉर्मर विथ ऑन लोड। ओके, नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट। व्हाट इज दिस ऑन लोड? हियर टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ प्रैक्टिकल ट्रांसफॉर्मर एंड इन दिस ट्रांसफॉर्मर वी आर गोइंग टू कनेक्ट अ लोड in the secondary winding. That's why I have written here practical transformer with on load condition. Okay, that means we are going to connect here a load in the secondary transformer. So let us start. What happen when we connect a load in the secondary winding? As you see here, this is a transformer. Okay, and in this transformer we have two winding. This is your primary winding and this is your secondary winding. In primary winding you have supplied a AC supply of V1 voltage, and when you supply this V1 voltage at the terminal of this primary winding, and this winding having a closed path, that's why I1 current start flowing in this winding. And due to this I1 current, what happened? An EMF induced in the coil, and that EMF will be suppose here E1. Here it is written, here is N1, where this N1 is the number of turn. Now, as you know that why EMF produced in this coil, due to electromagnetic induction principle. Okay. Now, as you know that due to this I1, a flux phi produced in this primary coil. And some part of this flux link with the core of this transformer. So the flux flowing in the core of the transformer is suppose here phi 1. Okay. Now this phi 1 link with this secondary winding coil due to mutual induction principle. And as you know that this winding having a closed path connected with a load, that's why due to mutual induction a flux phi produced in the secondary winding, and due to this phi a EMF induced in the secondary terminal, and due to that EMF and current, that is your I2, start flowing in the secondary winding of this transformer. So you can say that this I1 is equals to I0 plus I2 dash, where what is this I2 dash? I2 dash is the amount of current which secondary winding demands from the primary winding. Okay, and this I2 dash is just opposite to this I2. Okay, and what is this I0? This I0 is the core current. Okay, so from here you can easily understand that this I1 mainly supply two current for this transformer. First one is core current and second one is the current for this secondary terminal. That's why we can write here I1 equals to I0 plus I2 dash. Okay. When some load is connected between the secondary terminal of the transformer is said to be loaded, or it is said to be on load. Due to the load on the secondary current start flowing. Simple, as you connect the load towards the secondary winding, the secondary current start flowing. Due to increase in the load current I2, the secondary ampere turn N2 I2 will also increase. This increased secondary MMF, that is N2 I2, will increase the flux phi 2 set up by the secondary current. This flux opposes the main flux phi 1 set up in the core, and due to the reduction in the main flux phi 1, the induced EMF in the primary winding E1 will also reduce. Hence the difference between V1 and E1 will increases, and the primary current will increase. Okay, so the additional current drawn by the primary winding due to the loading is called as load component, which is denoted by I2 dash. And this I2 dash is out of phase with the load current I2. The current I2 dash developed its own magnetic flux I2 dash as shown in the above figure. Now this I2 dash is in the opposite direction to that of phi2. Hence, it helps the main flux phi1. Thus, the reduction in the main flux due to phi2 is compensated by phi2 dash, and the core flux phi1 will almost remain constant. So from here we can say that this primary current is your I1, and this I1 is equals to I0 plus I2 dash. Okay, now let's see the phasor diagram of the transformer with inductive load. As you know that in this case we have taken transformer with on load. Okay, means in the secondary of the transformer we have connected a load. Let's take a inductive load here. Okay, as you know that we have normally three types of load: resistive load, inductive load and capacitive load. So here we are going to take inductive load. Okay, as you know that when you connect inductive load in the secondary winding, what will happen? The voltage of this load leads the current of this load, and as you know that this inductive load is not here pure inductive. Okay, it has some component of resistance. That's why this inductive load, in the case of this inductive load, its voltage will lead the current, its current. Okay, by some angle. तो यहाँ पे देखिए आप समझ सकते हैं, अपन ने ट्रांसफार्मर का फेजर डायग्राम विथ नो लोड केस में अपन ने पढ़ा था कि E1 पहले इंड्यूस हुआ जो कि V1 से जस्ट अपोजिट है, क्लियर है? और यहाँ पर E1 और E2 दोनों फेज में है. क्यों? क्योंकि ये E2 प्रोड्यूस होता है ड्यू टू म्यूचुअल इंडक्शन विथ E1, बट इनका मैग्नीट्यूड डिफरेंट हो सकता है. अब E2 जो है, E2 ई एम एफ इंड्यूस हो रहा है, ये जो ई टू ई एम एफ इंड्यूस हो रहा है, ये होल ई टू वोल्टेज किसको मिल रहा है? लोड को मिल रहा है. ओके, तो लोड वोल्टेज कितना हो गया यहाँ? ई टू हो गया, और लोड में जो करंट फ्लो रहा है वो आई टू है, और अपन को मालूम है कि इंडक्टिव लोड है, इसलिए यहाँ आई टू लैग करेगा ई टू से. इतना क्लियर है? ठीक है. अच्छा, अपन ने अभी डिस्कस किया था कि लोड को जितना करंट चाहिए होता है वो I2 डैश के टर्म्स में, ये ग्रीन लाइन जो आपको दिख रही है, मैंने आपको बताया था I2 डैश I2 के जस्ट अपोजिट होता है. इसका मतलब ये है कि I2 करंट यानी लोड का जो करंट है वो उतना करंट प्राइमरी से डिमांड करता है, तो वो डिमांड के करंट को हम जस्ट डिनोट करते हैं I2 डैश. सो दिस ग्रीन लाइन इज शोइंग योर I2 डैश. ओके, ठीक है. अब अपन ने नो लोड कंडीशन में पढ़ा था कि V1 से लीड करता है I0 से, मींस ये I0 क्या है? ये वो करंट है जो कोर में फ्लो होता है, जिसकी वजह से कोर लॉसेस होते हैं. कोर लॉसेस के दो कंपोनेंट मैंने आपको बताया था, मैग्नेटाइजिंग करंट और कोर करंट. ओके, तो एक करंट हो गया कोर करंट और एक हो गया I2 डैश, और अगर मैं इन दोनों का रिजल्टेंट निकाल दूं तो यहां से हमें मिलेगा I1. तो अपन ने देखिए डिस्कस किया था कि I1 क्या है. I1 प्राइमरी करंट है और वो ट्रांसफार्मर में मेनली दो पार्ट में डिवाइड हो जाता है. फर्स्ट पार्ट इज योर कोर करंट एंड सेकेंड पार्ट इज योर लोड करंट. ओके, तो ये I1 लोड करंट को भी सप्लाई कर रहा है और ये I1 करंट कोर को भी सप्लाई कर रहा है. होप स्टूडेंट आपको ये समझ आया होगा. अगर कोई डाउट है फिर भी आप उनसे कांटेक्ट कर सकते हैं. ओके, थैंक यू.